Now, before we bring in our next guest, let's have a look at this outrageous bit of dishonesty from Climate 200 candidate Zoe Daniel, who is the teal in the affluent Bayside seat of Goldstein. Yesterday, she falsely accused John Howard of using gendered language because he referred to the fake independents as anti-liberal groupies.
I would say or suggest gently that gendered language like anti-liberal groupies is inappropriate in a democratic process.
Gendered language? Really? Let's have a look at what Mr. Howard actually said. This is what he said. These men and women are all posing as independents. They're not independents. They're anti-liberal groupies. Their aim is to hurt the Liberal Party, not to represent the middle ground of the electorate. Note the words there, these men and women. If Zoe Daniel identifies as a groupie or sees the word groupie as quintessentially female, that's on her. It's certainly not something Mr. Howard said or implied. But then again, misrepresenting what was said in such a blatant manner to smear a Conservative is on brand for the fake independents, who are well left of the Labor Party but pretend to be smaller Liberal alternatives. And what's more, they are maintaining the outrageous lie that they have no idea which side they'll back in the case of a hung parliament. Please.